In this election, the number one issue on voters' minds is the economy. And here in Tampa, the poverty rate in some of these neighborhoods is astounding, and unemployment continues to be a problem. In many ways, then, Tampa is ground zero on the I-4 corridor.
Okay, here we go.
For the Homeless Emergency Project in Tampa Bay, this is a day of celebration. The charities worked tirelessly to open their shelter for veterans, but it's also a stark reminder of the effects of a poor economy.
I do miss this house. I really do.
It's an issue former veteran Bill Hurley doesn't need to be reminded about. 2 years ago, he became ill, lost his job, and could no longer afford to pay the mortgage on his house. This is the first time he's been back since he left with his family.
Our son moved here with us, and then he went in the Army from here. So, you know, there's memories here.
For Bill and thousands of other families hit by Tampa's foreclosure epidemic, the economy is the only issue that counts in this election. Bill says he's voting for President Obama, but it hasn't been an easy decision.
This economy, the way it went, it's like everybody's struggling. There's so many people that are one paycheck away from being homeless. You know, it's unbelievable. And yet our government helps the banks, and they're not helping these people.
Man, look here, I want one of these world-famous cupcakes, man.
Small business owners, too, are deeply concerned about the future. Michael Dobbins and his wife, Eve, put their life savings into this cupcake shop and would love to hire extra staff. But they won't do that as long as President Obama is in office.
Obama's never had to start anything. I'm not even sure he ever had to start a dishwasher by pushing on. He's never had to go through the trials and tribulations of starting a business.
Tampa is the perfect reflection of what this election is all about. It's seen more than its fair share of hardship. Now its people will play a big part in helping shape this election and their future. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Tampa, Florida.